followed by المملكة الأردنية الهاشمية.
Mr. Chairman, Mr. Director General, distinguished delegates, let me begin by offering warm felicitations on behalf of my delegation to the distinguished Ambassador of Morocco on assuming the chair of the 22nd session of the Conference of States Parties. My delegation is confident that under your able leadership, Mr. Chairman, the conference would be guided to a hugely successful conclusion. My delegation greatly appreciates the work of the Technical Secretariat under the leadership of Director General Ambassador Ahmed Ousoumchou. Ambassador Ousoumchou has made immense and lasting contribution to this organization, and we are grateful to him for that. On behalf of my delegation, I congratulate and welcome Ambassador Fernando Arias of Spain as the next Director General of OPCW. We are confident that he will lead this organization to great heights. We assure our complete support to him. My delegation endorses and associates itself with the statement delivered by the distinguished ambassador of the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela on behalf of NAM States Parties to the CWC and China. Mr. Chairman, 2017 marks the 20th anniversary of the entry into force of the Chemical Weapons Convention, as well as the founding of the Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons. India attaches great importance to the Chemical Weapons Convention and stands for its full, effective, and non-discriminatory implementation. In this context, we welcome the completion of the full and verified destruction of the declared chemical weapons stockpile by the Russian Federation. With this, 96.3% of all chemical weapon stockpiles declared by possessor states have been destroyed under OPCW verification. We urge all possessor states to take necessary steps to expedite the destruction process. A number of states' parties have commemorated the 20th anniversary of the convention by organizing various workshops, training programs, and industry awareness programs. India has conducted a number of programs, including a chemical industry awareness program on CWC and an international phosgene conference. Similar events will also be held in the coming months. As we conclude the celebrations of the 20th anniversary of the establishment of the OPCW, we urge remaining states that are not parties to the convention to consider acceding to the convention at the earliest. Mr. Chairman, it has been India's consistent position that the use of chemical weapons anywhere, at any time, by anybody, under any circumstances, cannot be justified, and the perpetrators of such abhorrent acts must be held accountable. The use of chemical weapons is in complete disregard of humanity and is reprehensible and contrary to the provisions of the Chemical Weapons Convention, as well as accepted international legal norms. India views the Chemical Weapons Convention as a unique, non-discriminatory disarmament instrument which serves as a model for the elimination of an entire category of weapons of mass destruction. To this end, my delegation welcomes the efforts made and the progress achieved so far in the matter of destruction of the Syrian Arab Republic's chemical weapons and chemical weapons production facilities. We hope that the remaining task of destruction will be completed at the earliest possible time. We welcome the ongoing high-level consultations between the Syrian Arab Republic and the TS on the initial declaration by the Syrian Arab Republic and have taken note of the findings of the declaration assessment team. We recognize and appreciate the progress achieved under challenging circumstances and look forward to continuing cooperation between the TS and the Syrian Arab Republic. My delegation takes note of the 7th report prepared by the OPCW UN JIM and the diverse views on the same. We also note the work done so far by the fact-finding mission and look forward to receiving its reports on ongoing activities. Mr. Chairman, my delegation is deeply concerned with reports of acquisition of chemical weapons and their delivery systems by the so-called Islamic State or ISIS, and continuous use of chemical weapons and toxic chemicals in Syria and Iraq by terrorists. We believe that our work in the OPCW should help to eliminate the possibility of any future use of chemical weapons. Mr. Chairman, one of the core commitments pledged by each member state to the convention is to promote the peaceful uses of chemistry. This calls for international exchange of scientific and technical information and increased flow of chemicals and equipment across national borders for peaceful purposes. The provisions of the CWC should not be used for hampering these transnational movements. India welcomes the renewed emphasis given by the OPCW to the implementation of Article 11. We note that the OPCW has emerged as a forum for consultation and cooperation between the states' parties, including through exchange of ideas and discussion of best practices in the area of chemical safety. We appreciate the initiative by OPCW to intensify safety programs. We request that these programs also focus on small and medium enterprises in order to assist them in dealing with the challenges related to chemical safety and security. My delegation also notes the efforts of the chairpersons of the open-ended working group on terrorism and the sub-working group on non-state actors. Mr. Chairman, OPCW has attained much success towards achieving its goal of a world free of chemical weapons and the threat of their use. However, there is no room for complacency, as the ever-changing global security environment presents many challenges. These include the discovery of new toxic chemicals and technological advancements in deployment and dissemination of chemical weapons. Emergence of non-state actors further complicates the situation. The possibility of toxic chemicals falling into the hands of non-state actors, including terrorists, is no longer hypothetical. This calls for enhanced vigilance and increased adaptive capacity for the organization. In such a scenario, effective national implementation provides a safeguard against such threats. We urge all member states which have not done so yet to give priority to national implementation measures as contained in Article 7 of the Convention. Mr. Chairman, we value the importance of education and outreach programs in achieving the goals of the Convention. We are hopeful that all the recommendations of the advisory boards would be subject to detailed deliberations and decisions are arrived at through consensus. India is cognizant of the fact that often science and technology is far ahead of our understanding of disarmament and non-proliferation. The interface between emerging technologies and their implications on international security is of vital importance. It is therefore important to view the developments in science and technology from an interdisciplinary approach. India tabled a resolution on the role of science and technology in the context of international security and disarmament at the 72nd session of the UN General Assembly First Committee. It is heartening to note that the resolution was adopted without a vote by consensus, reflecting the collective will of member states. Mr. Chairman, my delegation recognizes the efforts of the two co-chairpersons of the open-ended working group on future priorities of the organization. The work of the OEWGFP should be guided and driven by states' parties and should address all issues related to the future of the organization in a balanced and comprehensive manner. We would like to see the work of this OEWGFP process proceed through established channels of the policy-making organs, bearing in mind time-tested methods of work of our organization, particularly decision-making by consensus. I request that this statement be circulated as an official document of the conference and posted on the OPCW's public website. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.